Yes.
After Darkness Fall, would you be interested in getting it more into the horror movie genre, or would you like to get back into it?
Oh, no. 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 We didn't shoot that movie, okay? Because anyone who saw it, I'm just sorry that you did, because that was like the worst movie ever made. And I saw it, I went Revolution Studios, they call up and like, okay, sweet, you can see the movie, the screening, whatever. And so, it's like a room half the size of this, it's like 20 people, suits and whatever, and I sit down, and I know what we shot, so I'm expecting something really interesting.
Right.
And then, and a 2-hour movie, no less, and then, it's an hour, I don't even know what it was, an hour and 20 minutes with a monster, and I'm just like, I don't know what this movie is, and I literally, when it was done, I just went into the bathroom and started crying, and my friend was there, I'm like, I'm never gonna work again. Like, what the hell happened? And we didn't shoot this movie. Like, we shot like a Sixth Sense. Like, that's what we shot. And I was doing Buffy at the same time, and so whatever. I knew that they had gone in to do some reshoots that didn't involve me much of it. There was 2 days I had to do in LA. Like, yeah, they fired the director, hired another one, had him go in and reshoot a bunch of stuff. They put in a monster. Like, there was supposed to be, like, in theory, a monster, but like at the very end, and even still, it was supposed to be questionable. Like, is the kid crazy? You're not really supposed to know. People aren't dying. Like, it's not that kind of movie, and I was like, oh my God. So, yeah, I didn't set out to do a horror movie, I guess is the answer. That wasn't. When we shot it, it wasn't actually a horror movie. And then they're like, we're going to put you in some stuff. What are those things called? Those things. Thank you, harness. That was the reshoot. Like, we're going to put you in a harness, now you're seeing a monster. Okay. Awesome. This. I'm like, no, it's at the end. Okay. And then, yeah. It all ended up going horribly wrong. But I guess some people liked it.
So.
Yeah.
I did. But
you
I
liked it.
No, I did.
Well, you did, yay!
I saw it because of you, and I said, okay.
No. Yeah, no, there's no amount of saving. Yeah, sadly.
I don't hold it against you. I know it's the studio.
And I look like shit. Which is what's really annoying. Oh, there's kids. Sorry. Thinking you're doing like a serious movie, so it's like, okay, great. I'm gonna look plain. I'm just not gonna be pretty at all. I'm just gonna simplify it, and of course, end up being a horror movie where you're supposed to look hot. So I didn't even get to look hot after all that. Shame. Anyway. Say that I did, honestly. I think I, there's just some parts that you just get very quickly. Like, you just get it. There's really not a lot of guesswork involved. And I had an impulse to read her in a particular way that thankfully Joss really liked, because it was supposed to be just a one-off. It was never supposed to go anywhere. And he, thank God, really, like, what is that? That's interesting. Do more of that. And then they just kept giving me more to do, which was awesome. It all just kind of made this wonderful soup that just, know, just kept getting more and more delicious every week. It was really great. And then apparently, is it Jane? I think it was Jane Espenson. Thank you. I should know that. That's awful. Apparently, it's very much like her. And I didn't even know that. I only knew that about the third season, third year in of doing her. And I was like, oh no, there's a lot of Jane. And then upon actually talking more to Jane, I was like, oh, of course. That's awesome. It is. You are like her. It's funny. I'm very, very grateful that I had the opportunity to do that. And it was very hard. I did, even after 5 years, I still was always kind of walking a line, making her not seem too dumb, not making her seem unlikable, keeping her just enough, just definitely skating the edge all the time, which was amazingly challenging and wonderful. So, I don't know if I'll ever get that again.
I'm glad you found
that.
Yeah.
A part of this is just you physicality-wise, you just have you're a short, cute, blonde thing, so it's like...
Wait, what? Oliver was short, cute, blonde. Well, what
I was going to ask was, when you're doing, when you're looking at roles that you're being put up for, now that you've been on a successful show for a few years and been really, I wouldn't want to say typecast, but that's what a lot of casting directors should think of.
Right.
When they go to your agent and they think, this is the girl who's been Buffy for 5 years.
No, I don't get that. I really don't. In fact, I can't even tell you how often throughout my career casting directors will say, but she's not funny. Like, I get that. Like, but she doesn't do comedy. Can she do comedy? I'm perfectly willing to own what I cannot do well. But I will give myself props for being funny. I can be funny. I'll do it. That's fine. So I was, that's always very surprising to me when I get that. Half the time it's because they don't consider Buffy a comedy, so they just write it off as a drama, which it just wasn't. And the other half, I guess they're looking for, kind of funny,
yeah.
Which is to me not funny. So if that's funny, then I'll be happily not funny. So I don't really ever get typecast. I actually wanted to do. I like comedy, and I have the hardest time getting seen for it. Like it's weird. Timer, I was actually able to be funny, but my kind of funny. So that's fine. But that's rare. No.